as we thought. But what position was I supposed to be in? Because when asking before, come in three parts. Two parts, I asked and made quite clear I would be more than happy to report and make public all three parts of that report. The only one I was able to persuade to come out immediately was that in and around the government. There are legal issues which all party leaders, I think, accept, come out and ask yourself. So I decided that really the way to deal with this is be upfront and honest and say, yes, I've made mistakes. I've not pursued things to the nth degree perhaps I should have, but also other people have been in that position as well. And we rely on professional trust, we rely on things being done correctly, but we must also be challenging. And that's what I am. By my nature, I've been challenging. And Jeff refers to the Cheshire Lions report. I wasn't happy with the response that I was getting. So I did take it to the end. It was almost a very embarrassing situation to be as leader of the authority to actually bring something about that led eventually to a bitter report. But I believe, had we had the right behaviours, and it's still the right behaviours there, that swift action could have been taken and we could have done things about that. And I regret that, you know, issues weren't followed through, and it does seem the report says we have a criticism of that. Is it right that the whole of the democracy of this of Wirral and the voting power of Wirral should be overturned on the basis of that report? It doesn't say that in the report quite clearly. There are clear guidelines in the report of what should be done next. And I, quite clearly, stuck strictly to that report. I didn't commission the report. And it does seem strange that a report under the strong leader model, and I've never felt I've used the strong leader powers and wouldn't want to, it does seem strange that we can initiate a report. I wasn't questioned by Ekranowski. I don't know who was questioned by Ekranowski. I don't doubt the report, because the question I asked myself before going into normal middle behaviour, which is normally one of denial, or they're wrong, we do things differently on the middle. Before going into denial, I took probably that's the first time, or yeah, probably in my life, I took a step and reflected on it. I asked everyone else who read the report to reflect on it and say, is this the middle image? Is this what Wirral's really like? And even only half of it's correct, then it's a pretty poor state of affairs that needs to be remedied. And I want to pledge my ability, because I want to make up for errors I've made, to actually turn that around and use that experience that I've gained over the years to be of use to not just the people who work for the council, but the people who receive the services from the council. And I did, thought, or like lots of people, thought when more and more issue was discussed, and our own mechanisms and people were compensated and apologies were given, that justice had been seen to be done. But clearly, I can't go into any other parts of the report, but perhaps I was wrong. And therefore, being the first politician who has ever made a mistake. But what do you do then? What do you do with that body of evidence to move forward? I think at one point, I must have been, I've done some inner reflection, of course, about my position. But Councillor Green's actually made it quite easy for me to stick around, because first he went on his block. Then he's added bits in to his vote of no confidence. That basically mentioned the facade and the lining issue. Well, that's clearly of a political nature, made to embarrass us even further. Well, if this report is to do anything for this council, it is to be a piece of evidence that we can all respond to together. If I play this, I bet people here in this room, as I look in this cell and say, have I done everything right? Have I pursued everything to the nth degree? And the answer would probably be no. So I want to use my experience of, if you like, getting some things wrong, to actually move forward with this authority with that experience, and embrace all the parties and everybody in. What I have done is stuck quite clearly to the guidelines. The first thing I recommended was that Anna Kronowski talks to all members, every single member of this council, and that has been set up. So hear it, if you like, not a very nice way, but hear it from the horse and cow, and then hopefully you will have the same experience I had, and take that on board for your quite clear at the outset of the year, and I'm not going to go back on that decision. We took responsibility for running this council this year as a minority administration. That's what we said we would accept. We will not and we cannot accept to be on a party, cabinet of all parties. We made that quite clear at the beginning of the year. So quite clearly, the offer of council being on an all-party cabinet is one that doesn't work, because evidence will say whatever combination we've used over those number of years, and we've had Lib Dem Labour administrations, we've had Conservative Lib Dem administrations, we've had all-party cabinets, it hasn't resulted in good corporate governance, whatever the reasons are. Now, I know it's easy to blame one individual, and that seems to be me tonight, but I'll tell you, I can tell you this, I promise to you, and everyone in this chamber, and all parties, I have invited, as best I could, and we met with the member of the I have said, I would invite the two party leaders as full co-opted members of the cabinet, under the constitution, I didn't invent the constitution, they will not have voting rights, but they will be heard, listened, and contribute to that committee to move us forward. As that committee is created and develops schemes of work, every single individual member in this chamber will be involved in the improvements and turning this council around. And quite frankly, we ain't got time to mess around with the political side and the political debate, because we have to turn this round, I hope, by next year. I believe many people have criticised the governance arrangements we have, and we have voted on this side for a notice of motion that looks at creating a new governance system. As you'll see from part of our amendments, which may need to fractionally amend because it puts too much influence on how people would vote at the employment committee, we'll make a minor amendment to that, I can assure you of that. But really, it's an unfair system where my job's on time. If you give us or give me the chance to continue, I will embrace and will change my way of operation to be completely and utterly open, transparent, more inclusive of other people and other parties' views, and try and move us forward. Because quite frankly, it's more important than my head gets locked off and heads will go in the phrase that they need from the press. It's more important that we get this right. And I would hope, by being the leader of the largest party, and still having the faith of my own group, and hopefully a majority tonight in this chamber, I will try and lead that in an open, progressive manner in the encompass of all parties. I give that promise and that pledge. Thank you.
Certainly.